Today on our special pensions focus, we'll be discussing a number of issues, including the value of the contributory pension scheme to contributors who are now retiring. Demola Sogunle, Chief Executive Officer of Stanbic IBTC Pension Managers, joins us to discuss this. Thank you so much, Demola.
Thank you. You're
pleasure welcome. To have you. Before we go into what we have lined up for today, let's just look at the latest development on the pension space. PENCOM has just issued a draft guidelines on withdrawals from the retirement savings accounts for equity payment of residential mortgage. I suppose this is significant, but share your thoughts on that.
Fine. Look, the important thing is that if you all, take, cognizance of the fact that we've got huge, housing deficit in Nigeria, that's number one. Number two is the fact that, look, by virtue of the Pension Reform Act 2004, revised, in 2014, we've got, huge, domestic savings. How do we, meet the gap, the deficit in housing? So in a very creative manner between the regulators and the operators, something was inserted in the Pension Reform Act 2014 to allow, contributors to tap into their balances in their RSA for the purpose of procuring, my mortgages. Now, PENCOM had issued this draft guidelines. And the significance of that guideline is the fact that we can use up to 25%. If you cast your mind back to the fact that, as we speak now, the AUM, asset under management in the industry, is almost 5 trillion naira now. 25% of that 5 trillion, you can say that, look, it means that potentially, right, we can deploy that in terms of trying to use that to secure mortgages from primary mortgage institutions or banks. So for us, when you combine that with what is happening with NMRC, maybe we've started to see, a major way of trying to reduce housing deficit in Nigeria. And the other significance is the fact that now the balance in the RSA, we can use it to start adding value to the contributors, instead of waiting for them to retire before we can pay them something. Now, if you are active, you are still working, you can actually derive value from your balance.
I'm just thinking about awareness. This is something good also for the contributor. So I'm just thinking, how much awareness should we begin to put out there regarding this?
Yes, we've got, let's say on our own part, we've been trying to do the awareness for the past 2 years. Eventually, it was inserted in the Act in 2014. Now, even before these guidelines, were issued, we've been sensitizing most of our customers, most of the employers. Of course, once it's finalized, we can go out there and actually generate the awareness. But one thing I know is the fact that most of the primary mortgage institutions, they are waiting for this. Most of the banks are waiting for this. Don't forget, most of them, they've got either housing finance units. Some of them, they've got departments in charge of mortgage. So they have been waiting, for the final guidelines. And once this had been finalized, of course, we can generate the awareness through many avenues.
Okay, so we can expect a dramatic turn of events within this industry. Because also, PENCOM is asking for feedback from stakeholders. You'll have till September 11. Yes. So, what kind of feedback should we be expecting?
It's just to make sure that there is proper alignment. We don't create.
But are you expecting, a broad agreement?
Yes, of course. All the operators, and don't forget. Look, there are so many stakeholders when it comes to housing. So apart from the fact that we, who are the operators in the pension industry, we will contribute. We should also expect, contributions also from primary mortgage institutions. We should expect contributions also from banks, right? And even those who are playing, in the construction industry, they could look at it. Even those in the insurance, sector, they will look at it, and they will all contribute. Because once we can make the process to be very seamless,
I suppose that's a sticking point, ensuring that the process
is seamless, is process driven, and is secure, then it's a press of a button. You apply, you get your contribution, you go to a bank, the bank gives you a mortgage.
Let's hope that you make it sound very easy. Let's hope that that's how it actually does play out when we see it come into full force. Now, let's move on. I mean, we're having a bunch of contributors retiring soon. It's been over 10 years now. Obviously, we know that Stanbic IBTC Pension Managers, you're the biggest pension manager in the country. Tell us about the experience of the retirees and how the whole contributory pension scheme has added value to them. They've waited for this moment.
You need to interact with those who are retired under the scheme. I'm telling you. You see, the peace of mind, I mean, you can't quantify it. You know, by the 19th or the 20th of every month, by the press of a button on our own side, through our custodian, our retirees, they get their monthly pension. It could be a weekend. You see, some of them will send text messages to you, to me, you know, thanking me. No, it's not my money, it's their money. But they are so happy with the fact that they didn't have to queue, they didn't have to beg anybody, they didn't have to bribe anybody, they didn't have to cajole or persuade anybody. It's my money, and I get it as and when due. Is unbelievable. If you look at the statistics, under this scheme, for 10 years, we've got over 100,000 retirees under this scheme, 100,000 Nigerians, right? Cumulatively, the scheme had paid over $250 billion. Right. That's for the whole industry.
Okay.
For Stanbic IBTC Pension, from inception to date, we've paid over 150 billion naira to retirees. On a monthly basis, we pay about 33,000 Nigerians. It's seamless. Imagine 100,000 Nigerians being despondent. Imagine 100,000 Nigerians, you know, not being able to receive their money. But now they receive their money, and you know the beauty of it is that the next person to the person receiving the money does not even know that the pensioner had been paid until he says it. So the confidentiality of the transaction is upheld.
Interesting. What about, I mean, returns? Because I've heard some PFAs talk about how they consistently deliver returns well above industry average and above inflation, and that you know, their contributors are very happy. Aside from, you know, the money they put together, there's that extra money on the side from the investment. What are your thoughts on that?
Yes, I mean, for us, return is very key. When we look at about three or four of our major objectives, you know. One of them is to make sure, to ensure that we are able to deliver what we call risk-adjusted return over the medium to long term. It's not to deliver, you know, top return just for one day. Don't forget, it's a medium to long term play, right? So one of the things we've done is that if we cast our mind back, from inception to date, we've always been above inflation rate, inception to date. So that's number one. Number two. In terms of when you look at the return we've given, let's say last year, 2 years ago, 3 years ago, there are instances where we've had double-digit returns on our funds. So the important thing is that we are giving risk-adjusted return. When you adjust for also inflation, it's still positive, and that is key. Because you see, for a retiree, what the person needs, right, is actually the security of the money, right? The security of the money, liquidity. Is the second important, you know, aspect for the person. Whenever I need the money, I can get it. Return is, I would say, is the third, you know, element, but it's not as important as security.
The cherry on top.
It's not as important as security and also the liquidity. But return, we are very good.
Okay,
in terms of return on investment.
I wanted to get your thoughts, because the multi-fund structure was actually meant to come in and make it, you know, even, you know, a better process. But yeah. It looks like, I mean, it's still going well, even without the multi-fund structure that's meant to categorize contributors according to their risk profile.
Yes, you see, the multi-fund structure will help us to decompose, you know, and actually, you know, put in place fit for purpose, you know, investment, you know, strategy for different, you know, contributors. For now, we are just lumping everybody together, which is not appropriate. Somebody who has just left school, somebody who is just starting to contribute, he still has about 30 years to contribute. You are using the same investment strategy for that person as you are using for somebody who is over 50.
Yeah.
You can't do that. So with a multi-fund structure, we will decompose. If you don't elect, we will use your age as a proxy of your risk appetite. Because if you are less than 30, we can actually put you in a portfolio of investment with let's say, higher percentage of variable income securities, because you still have, you know, a long way to go. And you can actually go through maybe about 4 or 5, you know, economic cycles, right? And to that extent is when you play in some asset classes, you know, listed equities, private equity fund, you know, unlisted equities, infrastructure fund, that you can actually, you know, get alpha. You can't get alpha by just doing it in fixed income. So we hope that once that is put in place, right, then we can put those kind of investment portfolios for those kind of customers.
Okay, we'll keep our fingers crossed on that. I hope that that can be sorted out as soon as possible. Thank you so much, Demola. It's been a pleasure having you today, shedding more light on that for us. Demola Sogunle, CEO of Stanbic IBTC Pension Managers, for our pensions focus today.